Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play The Elder Scrolls 3 Morrowind, as brought to you by my amazing supporters over on Patreon as per usual. We're just jumping on in here. It feels good to breathe some not quite Dagoth air. The skies are blue, everything is right in the world, and we have to go level our enchanting. I hate everything. So, what are we going to do this? Well, the place that we actually need to find is, I want to say, they don't let me zoom in. You can actually kind of see it on the map here, this like light colored spot right here. There is one of those portal ruins there, and we want to get there. So I think what we're going to probably do is... I'm trying to think of the quickest way. I think, let's see, we can Mage's Guild teleport to Wolverine Hall, and we're going to have to hold it. I'm going to want to rest first, because we are sitting on a level. And I'm hopeful, let's see, what's our intelligence? It's damaged, that's what it is. What is our intelligence? Still damaged. Yo, dog. 98. I am hopeful that resting will net us at least 2 points. Also, what is our luck? Our luck is 40. That's actually higher than I had thought it was.
Yes.
Luck is going to be a factor in our enchanting. I read up on the formula, and for constant effect items, luck does play a part. Well, for all enchanting, luck plays a part. So I think we can just sleep in a bed here. I'm just going to rest for an hour. Although, we should actually probably rest until morning. Seriously? Did I not? Am I 1 point off? I'm 1 point off. Crap. What can I do to really quickly gain a level? Because I want to get it to 100 intelligence. Alright, our restoration is actually right there. So let's run around and jump a lot while casting Restore Fatigue. There we go. Hey guys, we gained a level. What a twist. All right, but seriously though, I want to rest. We'll go 15 hours. I think that'll get us to about 8 in the morning. Okay, so yes, there's our intelligence. That's what we want. I also want, I'm going to take endurance. And we'll go with agility because it's got some points on it. I really should be leveling my luck. It doesn't add a lot. Like, at the highest end, with a 100 luck, it would give us a 12% chance increase, which I'll explain that here while we're walking. Excuse me. The way your chance to successfully enchant something works is that you have a base chance, and then it is modified by the cost of the enchant. Let me see if I have any actual soul gem. Here, let's go down to the Mage Guild and I can show you guys really quick. I'm not gonna actually enchant anything, but I can show you how it works. All right, so you come in here and you're like, Daedric Greaves, and I want, well, we don't have a soul, but you put stuff on it, like say this, all right. And there are enchant points, which we can't see because I don't have a soul gem in there. But based on the number of enchant points, your chance goes down pretty starkly. For a constant effect item, your chance to successfully craft it is reduced by 5% per enchant point, which is a lot. And what I'm gonna do right here really quick, because I keep forgetting to do so, is I'm gonna make us a better restore attributes spell. See if I can't maybe do like 20, just to kind of expedite it so we don't have to cast it on ourselves like 30 times. It looks like we should be able to do this, and it should be fairly cheap. Because the thing we have to remember is that casting this once is the equivalent of casting our other spell 4 times. So yeah, this is definitely looking like something we'll be able to work in here. Thankfully, we've been leveling our restoration skill. Let's see, endurance. I'm really not looking forward to doing this, guys. This is gonna be a pain in the ass. Well, maybe not. I'll probably just record the whole thing because it's not gonna be that bad now that I think of it, because I think we're gonna have to do like, what, 50 levels maybe? Here, let's do restore attributes greater. Bye. There, so we have a spell that's 4 times as potent and costs 4 times the mana. It's amazing how that works. But yeah, that should make it a lot more swift for us to be able to kind of crank our stats back up. Okay, so we're actually only gonna have to do 50 level, so that's actually not bad at all. I, for whatever reason, thought that our enchant skill was like 30 or something, and that would have been terrible. But your base chance to successfully enchant something is equal to your skill in enchanting, so for us that will be 100. 25% of your intelligence stat, which will equate out to 25, and then 12.5% of your luck. So, let's see, our luck will be 40, so that'll be like, what, 5, I think? I think that's right. Half of 40 is 20, half of 20 is, yeah, it'll be 5 points. You just keep halving and you eventually get where you need to be. All right, so we're gonna head north from here. I could take a boat, but it'd take me all the way up here and like, we're gonna be walking it regardless. And then, like I said, that gives you your base chance, so we'll be looking at 130 base chance, and then it'll be minus 5 times the enchant points required to enchant a thing. And the other thing that we're going to have to do is get access to Golden Saints, which, now that I think about it, what is our conjuration skill at? Our conjuration's only at 49, so that actually might be something that I will have to find a trainer for as well, so that we can actually cast the spell reliably. Because as much as I like the idea of roving the countryside trying to find golden saints to kill, I'd much rather just be able to summon them, and I know where the merchant is. The merchant's in Telbenora. It's the, like, southernmost town on this chunk of the world. So I know where we're going. I think we might have actually already been there. Yeah, we've actually already, Telbernora, all right. Yeah, there's a mage there that will sell it to us. I'll have to find him, but I'm really not worried. I'm mostly just looking forward to getting some stamina pants. I'm not wearing anything weird, am I? No, I've just got my common pants of stunning with an exclamation point that I keep forgetting I have. This can actually prove quite useful. There's actually an exploit you can do. I don't know if it's been fixed with the unofficial Elder Scrolls patch that I have applied, but when using items like these pants of stunning, let me see if it'll show it to me here. Does it say, is it, well, let me see here. Can't tell if that's actually casting. I can't tell if it's casting or not. But the amount of charges required to use a, like, on-use item actually goes down based on how high your enchanting skill is. And if you get 100, it's down, like, you know, however many percent. However, if your enchanting goes, I think, above 115, somewhere thereabouts, it reduces the on-use charge cost to 1, regardless. So, like, is this one? Yeah, this looks like it's only a point. When it lets me actually use it, which, I don't know, maybe it's immune, who knows. So yeah, that's something that's exploitable, but like I said, I'm not really planning on crafting stuff to really exploit the stat systems, because I think kind of defeats the purpose, because I would like the game to have some challenge to it. It's going to be markedly easier when we get access to this stuff, but I would still like, you know, like, I'm not going to have pants that give me, you know, heal 25 health a second type thing, because that's just, you know, ridiculous. I could, because of my alchemy, being able to brew enhance intelligence and enhance luck potions. There's also, I want to say, in Mournhold, there is a mage that sells enhance skill, a spell that lets you enhance skill. And, you know, I could make myself an enhance alchemy spell, for example, and I'm not going to do that, because I think that they didn't have it in the base game is a good thing, because then it makes, you know, like, you find some artifact that gives you plus 10 to swords or whatever, and that's, like, that's cool. Alright, so, this is the place that we're looking for over here. And screw off, you damn fish. I'm gonna kill this thing, too. Because I know! Do I have any potions left? Any stamina potions? I do. Beautiful. All right, I'm a quick save. I know who we're looking for here. I don't know what his name is, but he's a high elf. So we're gonna have to be kinda hopeful that calm creature works. It just needs to hit him. If it hits him, then I can go and bribe him, and then he won't want to murder us anymore. And once we've done that, then we can kind of proceed with making things work for us how we want them to. However, getting it to that point is going to be something that I need to be careful about. That might be him there. I don't know. I don't remember what he wears. Like I said, I just know he's a high elf. He's got a weird name. I'm gonna try and get up this way. That looks like a high elf, maybe? Are you a high elf? Are you a high elf? Who are you? Why can't I talk to you? Why are you running away? Oh my god. I'm gonna murder you. I've done nothing wrong. Leave me alone. Leave me alone. Screw off, ancestor ghost. You're nothing to me. Alright, but seriously though. Nope. It's summoning your ghosts. And he runs. Are you who I'm looking for? I think he might be running from his ghost, which is hilarious. Or maybe he's running from me. See, he shouldn't be able to. Oh no, he's actually summoning. For a second, I was for whatever reason thinking he was a dark elf. Are you who I'm looking for? Quit with your damn ghost summoning. I don't know why the game is making this so difficult for me. Like, it won't even let me target him. I don't know, I can't. Like I said, it's not letting me target him. So I'm gonna kill this thing and I'm gonna run away. Alright, I'm gonna quick save here. And we'll see if I can't sneak up on him, maybe. Because I don't think he'll know that I'm here. He might. He does. Who are you? I think this is the guy I need. Like I said, I don't remember exactly what he looks like. And we're running, you know, graphical mods anyways, so he might look different. So what I'm gonna do is we're gonna pull out, run away a little ways, get ambushed by cliff racers. Come on. Yes, you ass. I will not miss you once we are in Mournhold. Oh, that was a different one. What else is attacking me? A rat. Jesus Christ. It's as if nature has come to see fit to stop me here. Come on. There are not that many enemies nearby, game. I've killed, like, everything. There we go. Oh, let's just rest an hour. Hopefully this will, you know, reset his aggro. Okay, and we'll quick save. I'll be doing this a lot, because if we kill this guy, I'm going to have to level enchanting manually, and if we have to do that, I'm not going to do it, because it's a huge pain in the ass. All right. Where is this jerk? Just sitting over there. What was that? Oh, Wickwee. For a second there, I thought it maybe popped his name up. I'm like, that's strange. I turned on my mouse sensitivity so I can aim properly here. I don't know if he slowed his roll or not. Seriously, dude. Seriously, let me target his ass, game. Like, this is getting old. Worshipper. All right. Good to know. It's not who we're looking for, and I can murder him. Jesus. I don't know why the game is so fiddly about that. Sometimes it lets you target him just fine. Other times it's like, no, you don't get to target anything right now. And, like, that has been a problem with Bethesda's games for forever. It's in Fallout 3, it's in New Vegas, it's in Oblivion, it's in Skyrim, and it drives me fucking nuts because it makes it incredibly difficult to tell who your allies are when you're out and about. Note to Telvin. Telvin, stay out of this place has some sort of enchantment on it. I only got out because I cast a mark spell here before I went inside. Meet me back in Voss. We'll have to seek our fortune elsewhere. Alright. I could have sworn. Alright, yeah, here's the propylian chambers. These are the things you can use to teleport around. And there is a DLC, I believe it's called the Propylian Indexes, where you can like find them and use them to teleport around. I do appreciate that there's like a friggin' candle thing here. Let's see what's in here. Indara Yarn Yarn. Alright. Just keeping an eye out. Just in case. Also making sure we're not just like taking passive damage or anything. Yeah, let's go ahead and get our night eye going. All right, jump over here, jump over here. Random Dremora, sure, A plus. Chest with 25 gold. And he, in fact, did have a Daedric battle axe, which is nice, but not what I'm looking for. Ah, I think that's him right down there. All right. All right. Let's see, which one do we need? Do we need calm creature or calm humanoid? I think it's calm humanoid. There we go. Embrace your demise. Nope, worshiper. Ah. But, well, oh my god, I love it. You're the Nereverine, but a big hero. I don't really know how to talk to important folks like you except to say thank you for everything. Ah, that's okay. You do you. A tourist. You try to kill me, and I'm gonna kill your ass, though. Is one of them in here, maybe?
You'll soon be nothing more than a...
No, alright. I tried. I was gonna be merciful and, you know, not murder you. But you chose poorly. All right, so we have another worshiper there. An orc, maybe? Oh, man. I'm debating how I want to approach this, because this could be dangerous. All right, because that looks like a worshiper. Because this dude is a powerful spellcaster, and he will fucking kill me? Worshiper, worshiper, and are you a worshiper? I'm gonna guess you're a worshiper, because you look like the one I just killed. You guys are just worshippers, so I'm gonna murder you all. Come on. Alright. Yeah, I love it. It's like, I come in here and I'm like, we're looking for a mage, and then they're like, guess what? Mages everywhere! And I just kind of sigh inwardly. Frost Atronach. Too worried about that. I wonder if this game has backstabs in it. I think it does. I honestly can't remember. Frost Atronach is down. You appreciate the little jumping puzzles that they are electing to throw in my way, though. Let's see, Clan Fear. Ah, Dremora in there. Drink a stamina potion. Kill the Clan Fear. And that could be him right there. It's just... like I said, I just know he's in this area somewhere. I don't remember exactly where. Ah, nope. If you're gonna come after me, I was gonna say, come out here, because I don't want to be running in there and having, like, if that is him, having him throwing just all kinds of death magic at me. Because, like I said, the dude is a very powerful spellcaster. So, you know, I would really... hell. Really rather not kill him. You gonna calm down? You're gonna calm down, all right. But you stay calm. Alright. Oh, come on. Fucking climb the terrain. Corwin, yes, this is who we're looking. Because it's Corwin of Amber, you know? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna bribe. Alright, so now he should leave us alone. I am, however, gonna go kill that worshiper so that we can rest in here.
Your end is here.
Oh, you got some good points. They, oh, Arundel. You are Ring of Sanguine Unseen Wisdom. Fortify Mysticism. 5 points constantly. See, like, that's like a cool item. You can't make that shit in the base game. Once you get Tribunal, you can. But for now, that's like, you know, a unique piece of cool gear. All right. So, how much of a pain in the ass are you gonna make this? I wish that there were a quick way to do this. Okay, so I think he'll just sit right here. I don't believe he wanders around too much. Oh, he can also train us in destruction and alteration. I don't think he's the master for those. I know for sure that he is the master for enchant, though. Which, since its governing attribute is intelligence, us gaining levels from this really isn't going to do a whole hell of a lot. But we will gain... we will be gaining 5 levels, which I'm sure I have had banked for, you know, a while now. We'll rest an hour. And we'll go agility, endurance, luck. So I guess we'll be getting enough luck to squeak out maybe... I don't think it'll be enough to squeak out an extra point. And then we are gonna go and make something ridiculously powerful. Eventually, maybe. So we're gonna do this, and once we're done with this, I'm gonna go get us the Summon Golden Saint spell. I don't know if I'm necessarily going to go on an enchanting spree, like if we're gonna make an episode of that. I will probably, what I'll do if I had to guess is not intentionally leveling destruction. What I'll probably do is, once we have everything we need, I'll show you guys how it works. And then we will just kind of do our own thing, and I'll do any grinding necessary for, say, you know, summoning 100 golden saints off screen, because there will be some failures when it comes to this enchanting. So, you know, that's kind of to be expected. However, at a 75, I think we'll have enough to do some fun stuff. I don't necessarily know that we're gonna be, you know, making ridiculously powerful stuff. I will certainly be able to enchant a decent bit of something. I did not mean to do that. I will be able to enchant a decent bit of something onto my sword, which I'm really looking forward to, probably throwing some horrible form of death magic on it. It'll be nice. Agility acid. All right, and this is the way to level enchanting. Anybody that leveled enchanting like the hard way, you have my pity. I don't have the guts to do that. It is just incredibly tedious. This is just mostly tedious, but it also requires you to know where this guy is. I don't know how I learned where this dude was, but damn it, I just leveled my destruction again. I promise I'm not doing it intentionally. Not that I, like, 2 points is really gonna make a difference. And look. Alright. Enchant. 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 Enchantment. Not persuade. Almost there. Okay, so we are now a master enchanter. I'm gonna rest. And I apparently forgot to put a point into luck. Oh wait, no, that's... I did forget to put a point in luck at some point. I don't know. Now... Maybe Almsivi will get us to Vivek. We're gonna leave him alive because he's been useful to us. I like to imagine we just sat in this cave in the dark for like a week and, you know, it got us what we needed. All right, so we are in Alderaan. Oh man, we can take a mage's guild down to Vivek, I think. I'm so glad that is done, finally. What can I help you with? You can sell me souls, how about that? Speaking of which, let's see, I don't know if there's actually an enchanter in this guild. I'm sure there is. And I would like to maybe purchase something from them and see if we can't do something interesting. So you are the enchanter. All right. I love that people call you Nereverine and stuff. Like, it's nice to have a game that actually recognizes you when you've beaten it, unlike, say, Skyrim, where, you know, the guards still make fun of you and stuff, which is just ridiculous. Okay, Vivek, Guild of Mages. And then from here...
Hello there, how are you?
I'm doing great! I'm a master of everything. Also, I passed on godhood because it requires too much work.
You seem like very good company.
Alright, let's get out of here. Cat's Eye. I think I failed to cast Cat's Eye. I am a master wizard! Fear my power! Oh, Jesus, we're already at 25 minutes. That does not feel like 25 minutes. In that case, I think I'm gonna call it here, and next time we will get our Golden Saint summoning spell, and then I've gotta find a guild where we can actually purchase Grand Soul Gems. I know there is one, I just have to remember where it is, or one of you guys can just tell me where it is, because otherwise I'm just gonna end up like portaling between all the guilds until I find it. So I'm calling it. So as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time. I know this is kind of a slower episode, but I think after last time, Athalanth Last deserves to kind of just spend some time relaxing and not saving the world, or region, at least. But yeah, so take it easy. I will catch you all next time. Until then.